Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. We'll use provider state management for signing up, going to a new page, and loading information as well as do animation. So here I have this simple page, and I'll click on this signup page, and it will take me to a page like this. And here I'll type in my credentials. Now I'll click on the signup button. There was an animation and it took me this page. Now, if we go ahead and check our database. So I see info at dbestack. Well, to get started, go ahead and install these three packages. Provider is for state management. This is for network request. And this one is for animation. So this is the data we want to send using this post method. Now here we are sending our name, phone number, email, and password, and this is our endpoint, and we are hosting it in a local host. So as I click on the send button, we'll see, well, it returns a new response. And if we go ahead and check our database over here, this is a new record DBS tag, this one, and this is my email, which exactly we have just now over here. Here I created a new Dart class, which is signup model. The data we want to send will create a model. So here is our model. We have these four fields and then a constructor. And then we also have this JSON method, because this is the method we want to use before sending our data to the server, because we have to convert them to JSON. Well, we created another new class, which is called service class. So here, this is our service class. And over here, we have a method, which is called register. And at the top, we have used HTTP as HTTP so that we can use its object. Now over here, we created an instance named response from this response object. Now here, this is the http.post method. And over here, we are sending three parameters, URI, headers, and body. And at the end, if we get this HTTP response back, then we return the response, regardless it fails or pass. You see over here that we are passing our URL over here, and it contains our endpoint, just like we saw in Postman. Once again, this is very important. You have to send three parameters at least: your URL, headers, and your body. Now over here, before you send this data to database, make sure that you call this toJSON method, which we have seen early. We have seen early from here. So toJSON method. And at the same time, we make sure that our encoding has no problem. So we use JSON encode one more time. So this is our data class. And over here, we have this two Boolean. And at the same time, our method postData is receiving signup body as an object. And we pass this object to register method, which is over here. So we pass it to the register method, and register method encode it as a JSON and send it to the server. So we wait for the response, and as we get the response, we check it. If the check is 200, then we set this Boolean to true. And then regardless, whatever the response is, we set this loading to false, because we want to do an animation. And we will use this Boolean to go to another page. And at the end, we have this notify listeners. We have notify listeners two times so that we can get notified immediately as the Boolean changes different times. So this is our main.dart, and if you run it, you'd see a result like this. And inside this, we have created this multiprovider, and at the same time, we are using this data class to create a provider using changenotifier provider. And after that, we have this stateless class, which is my app. And from here, we are calling provider demo screen. And then from provider demo screen, we are just doing basic UI. And inside this provider demo screen, we have an onTap event. From here, we want to navigate to a different page. And then we have created this signup page. Signup page for our four fields, we have these four controllers. And then we have a registration method, and this method would get called later. Now inside this, we have all this UI. And over here, inside this gesture detector, we have this registration method. Inside this registration method, over here, first we are creating an object based on these four fields, because they are data controllers, so they can hold data. And we are getting all this data, and we are passing all this data to this signup body, which is over here. This is our model class. So as we pass data from here, it uses this constructor to make an object, and then we get this object. If we can get this object right after that, we'd be using it. But before that, we get an instance from our provider class, which is data class. So this is our provider class. So using this class, using provider.off, we create a provider object. And after creating this object, we can call this post method from this class. Do remember that this class has a method which is called postData. So as we have the object, we can go ahead and call this method. And this method would return us a result, and we wait for it. And as we wait for it, now there is a Boolean that might change, which we set inside this postData method. If the status code is 200, then we set it to true, which means that if it is true, then we can navigate to somewhere else. So we want to navigate to homepage. So we created a new class homepage, but here we just have pretty much some basic UI, and that's all. So right after everything, we'll go ahead and run our app. So now here we are. Now all we need to do, we need to go to our main.dart, and over here, instead of this container, we'll call signup page. Now we'll go ahead and run our app. Now this is our front page. If we click on this, we see a beautiful page like this. And over here, we'll use our email to. Now we'll click on this button. Now there is this animation. Now it went back to this dark screen. That's because we have a container over here. Inside this registration method over here, we are waiting for this callback. And if it returns and if it is true, we are supposed to navigate to a new page. But over here, we are using a container which is black. So all simply we can replace it with homepage. So now we'll do it one more time. So let's restart everything from the scratch. Now we'll click on here. Let's see how it looks. Now over here, we are in homepage. Now if we go and see our data over here, now let's go ahead and select this one. Now as you see, so this is the email address we just typed in. This is our name and this is the phone number. So anyway, if you learned something, if you like the video, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Thank you.